Welcome friends. So here we will demonstrate the procedure for development of the lateral surfaces of solids. So we will first take up the case of one pentagonal prism. When we are given the pentagonal prism, so we are interested in the development basically to manufacture this particular solid from sheet metal. So we want to know basically the size of that sheet metal plate, so which should be sufficient, and the marking on that sheet metal plate, so that appropriately we will bend it at those markings and we will get the required solid. So overall what we do, we assume let us say in the top view, so A, B, C, D, E, and back to A, so that all lateral surfaces which are visible here, so they should be developed in true shape. So their true shape should be drawn on the drawing. So what is the procedure for that? So one procedure which we can use on AutoCAD, I'll demonstrate. So first of all, so here you note the height of the solid, so that is equal to the height of any of the vertical edge, so that is true length. So on the sheet metal which is to be developed, or from which this solid is to be developed, or in other words we can say the development of this solid, so its height will be equal to the height of the solid because it is true length. So on development every length is true length because it is basically the true shape of the lateral surfaces put on single surface. So first of all we copy one of the edge, so we copy one of the edge, with this as the base point. So now we have this vertical edge. So what we need, this is let us say we are starting the development from AA edge. So we have AA, some distance apart we shall have BB, some distance apart we shall have CC, DD, EE, and then again we shall have AA, so that this round complete, we have a complete round about it. So overall in a pentagonal figure, so we will have six, when pentagon we have actually five vertical edges, but in the development we should have six, so that five surfaces ultimately we should have. So we can use the array classic command, so array classic, so we can use the rectangular array. So number of columns we need, number of rows, that is one, so number of columns, because we need six number of those objects or the vertical edges, so we have put six columns. So row offset distance is immaterial because there is no row, no second row. So column offset distance, what it should be, so column offset distance is to be given very carefully. It should be equal to the base edge length. Note that the base edge length here is 4 grid spaces, and 4 grid spaces according to our scale is equal to 1 AutoCAD unit. So column offset distance should be equal to 4 grid spaces, which is equal to 1 AutoCAD unit. So that is why we have kept this distance as offset distance as 1. If there were 5 grid spaces, then this offset distance should have been 1.25. For 6 grid spaces, the base edge, if it is 6 grid spaces, then it should be 1.5 AutoCAD units. So here 4 grid spaces, so 1 AutoCAD unit is the column offset distance. We select the object to be arrayed, so this is the object to be arrayed, press enter, and the column offset distance is given, number of columns are given 6, and this way, so So we will get the whole of the plate. So the plate, it starts with this and it ends here. So this also is AA, the other end is also AA. So we can label for your reference. So here we will call the solid has been developed using the vertical edge AA. So let us label it. Let me use the capital letters because all are true lengths here. So A, B, here C, C, D, B, and here we have E, E, and again it comes back to A. And you know it is just for identification, so we can even locate it at the bottom. So in completion of the development will be, we should complete this solid figure. So from this point to this point we join, and this point to this point we join. So this way we complete the development of the prism, pentagonal prism, like this. Thank you.